Hi everyone, this is Lahiri from ABCs of Anesthesia, and right now I'm going to be demonstrating the front of neck access or surgical airways. Now, this is in the context of your difficult airway algorithm. So for example, whatever algorithm you're using, whether it's the difficult airway society or the vortex approach, you're going to be trying all the different methods of supraglottic airway access. For example, you might be trying to bag mask and optimize that, use an LMA or intubate with laryngoscopy, and maybe even try a video laryngoscope. Now, if all of these things are failing, that's when you need to start preparing for a surgical airway. And so that's what we're going to go through. So let's get started. Now to keep going down that algorithm, if you don't have palpable neck anatomy, you'll need to use a different technique to try and expose the neck. So the first thing you do regardless is to still try your needle crack technique, but you might want to try a different approach. So similarly, I'll take my 5 mL syringe, 2 mL of saline there, take my 14 gauge cannula, remove the back of that, and say this after doing the laryngeal handshake, it's not successful. So, you know, I don't get the aspiration of air, and that's all good. So now I know that my trachea is going to be deeper. So I might want to do some more vertical incisions so I can actually reach the trachea. So I might start in the midline, and let's say that fails. I then take the cannula and needle en masse and try maybe 1 cm to the left and right. And if that doesn't work, I'll try the other side. Again, that doesn't work. Now, you might want to do this just a couple more times, trying to find if you can actually find the trachea. Now, note that I'm not angling the needle. I really want to see if where exactly that trachea is. Angling is not going to help as I'm going to be going down, into a different plane. So I systematically go lateral to the midline to try and find the trachea. Now, if that fails, I need to try something different. I take my scalpel and I make an incision that's about 6 cm down what I perceive as the midline. Now, there's going to be some blood there, so I need something like gauze to just stop the bleeding. I then use my gloved fingers in a sterile fashion as possible to try and divide the muscles there to try and feel something that's familiar. Now, at this point, I now have gone from quite a large neck to something that I can feel the anatomy. So then again, I use my similar technique with a needle crike and get that positive aspiration of air. And now this is exactly how we taught before, a needle crike technique. Take the needle out, put that safely in a sharps container, aspirate for air, it confirms I'm in the right position, and then connect this to a jet ventilation device. So thanks so much for watching this series of videos. I hope they were really useful to you. Please share with anyone who might be interested, and we'll see you next time for the next video.